welcome to Gab and Jam. That was the jam. What was that for?
That was from the baseline for Honey.
The baseline for Honey, which is our first single, yes. Which you'll find out a little bit more about.
All right.
In an episode. This episode, however, piggybacks on what is going on with the Ellen DeGeneres show, hostile work environment issue.
Yes.
So our topic is, how available should an artist or an entertainer be?
Or I guess that, and how true, I guess, to their brand should
okay.
they be 24/7?
Okay. All right. I like that.
You know what I mean?
All right.
So,
I like that.
So I think it's kind of twofold, because it seems like with Ellen that I'm getting that people who went on her show mm-hmm. or involved with her felt like they were kind of involved in a bait and switch.
Right, you know? Right. Because she seems so friendly and so nice.
She seems so friendly, so outgoing, all the rest of this type of stuff. So, you know, and I guess that, you know, whether it was people who were working on the show
mm-hmm.
or even people who were dealing with people who were coming on the show,
mm-hmm.
you know, they're kind of told stuff, don't be too funny, you know, don't try
right.
to out funny
Ellen. Right.
And then I guess, you know, in between, you know, takes with the audience, Ellen would look at the audience.
Right.
She would interact
at her notes,
with the audience
right.
and that kind of thing. And so the question then became, you know, or like she was tough on her staff.
Yeah.
Or someone was tough on her staff. I don't know if she was directly
mm-hmm.
doing this thing as much as, it, you know, it may have been, you know, producers or whoever else were working on the show.
Mm-hmm.
I should say probably directors who are working on the show. Producers, I'm thinking in terms of studio and music, but, you know, the directors mm-hmm. or whoever was working on the show, that, you know, these individuals are very difficult and all the rest of this kind of stuff. So the question then becomes, you know, as Ellen is getting this barrage of stuff,
right.
and, you know, and now kind of having to do, you know, save face
yeah,
and all the rest
yeah.
of this kind of stuff,
yeah.
you know, what is a realistic expectation with respect to you as an artist, you know, and what your brand is,
yeah.
and then your obligations to your audience.
Right, because that's what we were saying. That artists are usually more accessible now, and even with Ellen and some of the others, if you go, or, you know, John Legend or whoever else,
right.
if you go to their Instagram, they're showing you pictures of their puppies and their kids and their whole
yeah.
life. And so things are different.
Things are different.
Back
yeah.
with Prince, we never.
Prince,
I mean, you,
Michael Jackson, you weren't their friends.
Right, you weren't their friends, and you didn't know what happened behind, unless they invited cameras and it was a
right.
big deal.
But yeah, but there was never this. They were, I'm not going to say comfortable, because, you know, clearly both of them had issues, right? So I'm not going to say comfortable, but they were in this position of loftiness.
Yes.
You know, that I think that it's kind of a little bit different if we look at, you know, Lady Gaga with the Little Monsters.
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And, you know, Taylor Swift with her Swifties. And Beyonce with her Bayhive.
Right.
And those type of people. And I think Beyonce is a little bit different with her Bayhive than
yeah.
the way Lady Gaga and Taylor Swift are. I mean, because, like, when Taylor Swift was going through this whole thing with Scooter Braun.
Oh, yeah.
She basically sicked her Swiftie on Scooter Braun.
Get him.
Yeah, you know,
yeah.
kind of like, yeah, yeah, he's doing this. And then he start actually getting, like, death threats
oh,
and
wow.
all the rest of this kind of stuff. So again, it's this type of thing of this responsibility
mm-hmm.
that artists have, you know, they have to understand
yeah.
the power in their
yeah.
words.
Wow.
But at the same token, there's also this other aspect that, you know,
human.
Do you even court danger for yourself,
right?
Or just a lack of privacy for
yeah.
yourself, and the fact that your Swifties, they may come out, see you eating someplace, and feel like, hey, they can just come up to you and talk
right.
to you.
Right.
You know, and,
yeah.
and that's...
Or
so
even criticize.
Those,
the
right.
other part that I was seeing is that on some social media platforms, that if people share, you know, hey, them throwing their baby in the pool at, you know, 3 months old,
right.
that there are people who are, like, outraged. Like,
right.
okay, first of all, this is not your child. Second
right.
of all, the child floated. You know, again,
right.
they're, you know, doing their parenting, or they're eating, or they exercise.
Right.
And they kind of leave it open because they shared that
right.
to be criticized. And I know that that has been one of those kind of slippery slopes. It's
right.
like, yeah, you want to be friendly, but do you really want your fans telling you how to live your
right.
life?
And I don't know how much that actually comes from the fans or if it comes from other people, you know, because
okay.
once you open yourself on the social media, you're gonna have your fans and critics alike.
Yeah, that's true.
Who are gonna, you know,
give you some advice,
right?
What they think you should be doing.
Who's gonna come after you?
Yeah.
You know, so I mean, but kind of going back to the Ellen thing, is that sort of like, you know, I have a certain amount of empathy for, you know, what happened on her show. So many that when you kind of come on her show, to some extent, you're kind of seeing how the sausage is made.
Yeah.
And that it might not be a very pretty process.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it, you know, it's sort of like if you went to go find out from beginning to end how that hamburger ended up on your plate.
Right.
So you saw the cow get slaughtered.
You saw
them gutted and all the other kind of stuff that they do. That's not necessarily a pretty process. And
yeah.
So I'm thinking that if you got a highly rated show like Ellen's show,
mm-hmm.
you know, the way that you run that show
mm-hmm.
might not be pretty. I mean,
right.
it might be a highly,
yeah, because we've actually seen this before years ago, but it wasn't as publicized.
Right.
As we had it with Oprah, and they've had it with Jay Leno. But with Jay Leno, they said, oh, it's his manager is the bulldog,
right,
and it's not him. He's so sweet.
Right.
Whereas with Ellen, she's fielding the actual, you know.
Yeah, because she's you know, people see it as she's ultimately being responsible. And so a lot of people are saying, hey, look, you know, I worked there, and it was really bad. It was this. And, you know, as long as you're not going through something like sexual harassment, you know, something where you're being bullied, but if it's just high pressure,
right?
I mean, that's
this is entertainment,
kinda, right? This is kind of par for the course,
yeah.
You know, that's kind of what the expectation
it is.
It's gonna be long hours,
right.
It's gonna be high
fast,
pressure,
right.
And a lot of times it's gonna be little pay,
yeah.
You know, that there are certain people that make a lot of money, but I think the vast majority of people who work on this stuff, don't make tons and tons of money,
no.
And that's because there's tons and tons of people who are just dying for that opportunity.
Yeah.
You know, and
yeah.
So, I mean, that's kind of, you know, I mean, that's the way it's done. And you know, and if you're naive enough to kind of feel like, oh, no, it's like a regular office down the street, like a mom and pop type of.
No.
It's not.
Mm-mm.
It's not that type of operation.
No.
You know, it doesn't function that
the
way.
The other part is that she is a human, maybe between takes, you know, because they're saying, oh, she's not engaging with the audience. She's not looking at folks. That maybe you need to recoup your energy. The other part about now being on stage all the time and social media and all this other stuff and people being paparazzi and everything else is that sometimes you just want to sit and reflect on your thoughts.
Right. Oh, no, it's just sometimes you don't fucking want to be bothered with anybody. You know what I mean? I'm just saying. I mean,
well,
yeah,
especially
I you got
as artists, right?
Right. I know you had a job.
Yeah.
You know, you could have had a bad day at home. You could have had anything. You know what I mean? Just sometimes.
Yeah.
It might just be better to not say anything.
Then to cut somebody out.
Right. You know what I mean? Just to, you know what I mean? Just something.
Or just bust out crying.
Right.
We don't want that either.
We don't always have great days.
You know.
We don't.
And not as human. So that, there you go. We're human.
Right.
And that's part of it.
I mean, that's just it. Just sometimes you have that. You know, so the fact that, I guess, for Ellen, that they feel like, oh, she's always supposed to be, oh, and you know, and don't get me wrong, you know, at the same token, you know, I'm not crying crocodile tears for Ellen.
Right.
So, that's, you know, true. So I can't necessarily say it's completely unreasonable, meaning that she's making millions and millions of dollars.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and they're probably saying, you know, yeah. You
so
know,
you
we do expect you. You need
right?
to be on this part of you doing your job.
Right.
That you're supposed
true.
To be on like that.
Yeah.
And this is what we expect. And maybe she's going to have to work that out.
Yeah, that's true.
You know
true.
What I'm saying? At the end of the day.
Yeah, she might have to go to the bathroom if she wants her private time. Right.
She might have to, because now she might have to, you know, start working through it, doing that banter. That might be kind of part of the job that they're expecting her to do now.
I think that's what Oprah did, because that story went away.
Yeah.
The second reason why you might not want to be as accessible is that you might want to actually have a private life.
Yes.
You know, go out and do things without a disguise. I know when Michael Jackson used to go out, he'd have a disguise on, or, you know, some of these other people. But maybe, or Sia. But maybe if you just want to go out and conduct business and they already know what you look like and you don't want to do all of that, then that might be a reason to not be as sharing. Hey, I'm going to the local store, you know.
Right.
Because there are some people who share everything.
Yeah. And you know, and sometimes I think it depends on, like, the type of fans you have.
Yeah.
You know, because you kind of get sometimes at the Springsteens of the world that they don't necessarily have those issues.
Yeah, yeah.
You know, I mean, so I don't know it's
maybe your brand, maybe your types of fans.
Right, but then again, I do think that there is a certain amount of distance between, you know, Bruce Springsteen and his fans.
He's back in a different era.
Right, you know.
He probably doesn't share his breakfast cereal and everything.
Right, else, so, he's not doing that type of thing, you know, with everybody all the time, you know. So, you know, and there were certain people, too, that, you know, that kind of part of their brand was that they were horrible when you met them. And then one person like that I hear was Lou Reed. Lou Reed was just not a nice guy, you know, and that, you know, like there was one person who said, yeah, you know, I ran into him one time and he was actually pretty decent. I was kind of disappointed because I wanted him to be a dick to me.
You got your cell phone out and you're ready. So let's capture it.
Yeah, but he too came from a different era, in this particular era, I don't know.
Yeah.
Like you say, I mean, people have that cell phone type of stuff. They put it out there. Yeah. Oh, he's a horrible, horrible guy. You need not to go near a new, you know what I mean? So, I mean, again, we do have an era of heightened sensitivity.
Yeah. You know, openness too. All this awareness of.
But the public is so sensitive to certain things, and you know, you can hurt people's feelings. So easily. You know, nowadays, and so that's a part that makes it a little bit harder too. You know, because a lot of times people don't have that. A certain amount of thick skin when it comes to this. So,
and then another final reason why you definitely want to think about how accessible you want to be is because there are still some nuts out here. And mental illness is, you know, a serious issue. I don't want to downplay that, but I do want to say that for some people, they become obsessed with you. And with the internet, you can find anybody.
Right.
Stan
you, right?
Yeah, they will stan you. And I'm thinking about, you know, people like John Lennon who suffered, you know, at the...
John Hinckley Jr.
Went out and, you know, so again, there are people who... they become so obsessed that it's a danger to you, you know, or even with Kim Kardashian with her sharing, hey, I'm at this place with all this jewelry, and then she got robbed. It's like, you know, personal safety is part of it.
Pop Smoke, the rapper who had the same thing happen, he went on social media, kind of showed all his money, all that kind of stuff, and they went out and they robbed him and that kind of thing.
So you do have to kind of, so there might be a little bit of a barrier, you know, that might be healthy to keep. And I guess for us DIY rock stars, we're so close to being normal people. I mean, you know, we're normal people.
Well, we are normal people.
All right, well.
You know, we're not, celebrities who are, you know, whatever.
So that's even more reason because we're probably even more accessible. So there is a reason to be hesitant to share every bit of your business all the time.
Yeah.
Even as you share your art with people.
Right.
What do you think? Do you think stars have an obligation to be accessible to their followers or fans? Or do you think they should maintain some sense of privacy?
Yeah.
Let us know. What else?
So we got the Funk album.
We got the Funk album. And in fact, you can go to bandcamp.com/Pregippy. I'll put the code on the screen and in the description. I'll put the link. So that you could pre-save the date tentatively for the actual CD is September 25th, 2020. But the digital album will come out on September 25th, hook or crook.
Yeah.
And we also have some other goodies like t-shirts and stickers and things like that. So make sure you check that out.
Yep. And what's the date that the first single?
The first single is gonna be dropping September 25th, 2020. So the date of the album drop is the first single. First single is Honey.
Yeah.
So yes. If you dig the vibe, be sure to
subscribe.
We're wishing you love, peace, and
chicken grease.